Kia ora tātou. Whai ora tēnā, that I was very reminded of hearing all of you come from, because you saw me writing and actually listening to all of you. There are different huahuatau that have come out of exactly what you were saying. But first of all, I'd like to introduce myself as well. Mā ngā pāpā kwa urama tāua kui tau haimihi. Taurama te moana, ko Ngāti He, ko ngā Ōtiki, thank you now and then. Ngāi te rangi, Ngāti Rangi ni ngāi. Mā ngā pāpā kwa urama tāua kui tau haimihi. Tāhuno rangatāua ki rā taku ukaipō, nō reira a irunga I rā kōrero, kumihi atu ki a koutou. I always said that my background, I am a symbolic, I'm a crab of rangatāua. That's a metaphor. That's a huahuatau. I'm a crab from rangatāua, and that is where my ukaipo is, my breastfeeding mother, motherland. So I purposely used that to introduce myself because, you know, it's good to hear how people introduce themselves and how they identify themselves when being introduced to someone. Nō reira, whai ana te whakarongo ki a koutou kōrero. Today our kōrero is on huahuatau, and I thought to myself, huahuatau, I've never heard of that before. So I must admit, I looked it up in the internet, and of course new words keep coming out. Ka puta puta mai ngā kupu hau. Yeah, and these are all, hey, this crow has relations, hey? Hey, tēmo te karetu, pare huia noroi and pau tēmara. But anyway, that's the way language evolves and moves around. And so, in looking at that, when I saw metaphor, I thought, we have lots and lots of these things, huahuatau. And let me just take some of the things that came out of some of your kōrero. Now, tūhoe kai ki ore. Tūhoe is, you know, they think no other iwi exists in my heart.
Kia ora, kia ora.
I wrote that up and I'm right in the middle and I said, what about us? But tūhoe kai ki ore, that means they eat rats. Right. Literally, that is. Whether they do or not, we don't know. We have to ask this krauna, okay? But see, that is a recognition of where they come from. Tūhoe mōmō kai. Banishes food. Food is of no consequence to them. Mōmō kai, mōmō taonga. Taonga is of no consequence because they will stand up and be counted. He tika e rā kōrero. So kai ki ore, that's really saying where they come from. Doesn't mean they literally eat rats. May have in the past, but we've got to ask their people, the historians. Now I look further down. Kāwhia. Now who all came from Kāwhia, or comes from Hawaii? Kāwhia. Kāwhia moana, Kāwhia tangata. Right? I don't know if Kāwhia was a person. But kāwhi, it's really putting a person where they come from. Whakauruatu te tangata ki tō rātou ukai pō. So this has come out of the kāwhia. Kāwhia kai tangata, not kai tangata, kāwhia tangata, kāwhia moana. Moana is physical, so you're there, the moana you can see. But kāwhia tangata, is kāwhia a personal other, or are you referring to the people there? So that's where you bring out what your metaphors or what your huahuatau mean. Okay? Yeah. Now looking at the different tūranga wāwai. Tōku tūranga wāwai. Okay? Tōku mana ko tūranga wāwai. Mana. Is mana something we can feel? Right? Aua, I'm not quite sure. You have to think that individually. Tēnā, tēnā, tēnā o tātou. Right? That is what mana means to you. That's okay. But when you look at mana, it's not something we can grab. It's something we feel. So it's emotive, emotions. It's psychologically, ka ka pāki tō hine ngaro, tākiri tō hine ngaro, tākiri tō manawa. And what I'm saying is it strikes at your heartstrings, okay? Ngāti pāua, I think there was a whakatauki in Ngāti Pahau, but I'm not quite sure what it is. And I think that particular whakatauki has something to do with the sea, but I won't repeat it. Kare hau e whakamārama i te rana, me hara nō kuake, nō reira, me waiho, but at the same time, they have those whakatauki or waiata, which bring out the huahuatau. I was listening to someone talking about karangarua. Someone said karangarua. Karangarua?
Living.
Right. Different callings, right? Ngā whakapapa, maha. He kanga, karangarua, he karanga whānui. Aku karanga maha. And we say it a lot in Mātātua. Ngā karanga maha. The many, many callings. Can we grab callings? No, we can't. No. But we can refer to them when we're talking about our people, our many tribal roots, our bones. Not literally, bones. Hey, you're my bone, or you're my foot bone, or you're my toe bone. So those are all huahuatau, types of huahuatau. Okay? So these all came out from Te Arawa. Aroha mai, Te Arawa. Mm-hmm. Now there's a good one, and I'm part of my father's Te Arawa, so I'm going to say it. Te Arawa mga nui, big mouth, right? Now, it doesn't mean big mouth in the sense that they've got big mouths, right? It means that the speakers in the past were brilliant, and probably now as well. So when you listen to those kinds of things, it brings out the, first of all, how our people look at the world, o tātou tūpuna, pēhā tātou titiro ki te ao, and how the people, mā iwi o tēnā rōpū, from the different tribal groups, interpret themselves. Okay? So as I said, I'm a pāpaka. Well, and someone said to me one time, yeah, you all go backwards. And I said, excuse me, because that was from Tūoi, I want to be Timutimu. And I said, excuse me, we go forward. So there you are, you know, to have humour, but it has real meaning for those people who own those huahuatau. Okay, that was just to listen to you all. But anyway, now I'm going to... Oh, just one other. I heard e ako e koroa i whakai huakoi te ingo o kengi tūheitia. Ngā tika hoki tēnā mai a tātou o te motu. Kengi tau a tūhe, te whare tapu. Te whare tapu o kengi tūheitia. It's not a physical house, but it is how we in Māori don't get a collective of people, right? A collective of people. Whare, and the sacred house, it's like the House of Windsor. Te tātawi tira, te whare tapu o te kuini o Ingarangi. The sacred house of the Queen of England, or of the English aristocracy, okay? So that's a metaphor. Right? And there was one other that one other thing that Wiremu said was, oh, this is beautiful. When he was doing his mihi to me, that's why I listened very, very closely to what's being said. He said, kua haere rātou I ngā huarahi e mahana tonuana. They, those that have passed on, are moving on the pathway, still warm, to the spirit land. What does that mean? As I gather, he was talking about those that have recently died. Mahana, still warm. Okay? Mahana, still warm. Alright? And when we go a bit further into my kaupapa, to our kaupapa, you will see how the environment is taken. Ka tiki nātu te taiao, ngā maunga, ngā moana, ngā awa, ngā whetū, everything in the environment is taken and made use of by our people. For example, maunga, whakairinga kōrero, where I hang my words. Do we hang words on the mountain? No, we don't, right? But that is the metaphoric, the huahuatau way of saying, that is where I generate my kōrero from. That is where my inspiration comes from, all right? Anyway, those are just examples to start with.
Kia ora whaia. Ah, ka pai.
Yes, can we just flip it up? Now, kupu huahuatau, metaphors. We've taken the English word because Tārangi asked me to speak in both languages. Whakapai hoki tērā, kia māra mai ngā taha e rua. Those are what are called symbols or tohu. In our language, they're called tohu or symbols. Tohu are things that are indicators. In other words, things that are important to each iwi. Right, Japan, for example. What's important in Japan, would you say?
The rising sun.
Exactly, the rising sun.
Yeah.
So that's a form of huahuatau. What else?
Cherry
blossoms. Mm. Okay. Right, now I'm going to get you to do something. Three of you. Two. Right, have a look at something that you think is a metaphor in different countries or here. Okay. Maybe a mountain, maybe a river, maybe a tree. Okay, now can we go around the class, please? Okay.
We have flax, and also the rising sun, the first light, because the light transfers from New Zealand.
Yes, it does.
And that means in a Christian sense, quite often, we create new moons.
Well, I can see what you're saying. Yes, first light. Yes, you see the light.
Yeah.
Right, it can sort of be interpreted in different ways, really. The first light, I've seen the light. That's what we do sometimes when we talk about religion. Well, ki te hau I te ao marama, I have seen the light because I went to church or something like that. Or I believed in something. Not that that is the only angle, right? There are lots of angles. Okay, thank you. First light.
What
else?
Yes, something to do with the white caps, yes.
So ours, we took ours out of the Whakatauki from the Whanganui River. I rere kaumai te awanu mai te kahu maunga. Ki tangaroa, ko au te awa, ko te awa ko au. From the mountain to the sea.
Ka pai. Carry on.
From the mountain to the sea, I am the river and the river is me.
Me.
Ka pai.
Kia ora.
Now, what are they doing? What is, and I'm glad you've got that because in my PowerPoint, there's something else that Whanganui, in the Whanganui River claims, Waitangi Tribunal
yes,
claims,
I
has said. What did our
Hakaraya.
What did our great student here say? I am the river.
And the river's me.
What is that saying?
We cannot live without each other.
Is she a river?
No.
Right. So what is that saying? What is that saying in actual fact? It's saying
moving,
yes, but something. That's good.
Belonging.
But there's something more important, more basic.
Connection.
Titiano tana kōrero kihea. Titiano tana kōrero kihea. What is she saying, really?
We are nothing without our river. We are without, if we do not have our water. We do not survive without water. We are one with our water.
Yes, we are. That's all great. Kapoi.
Is it,
one with
is
the
it,
river.
We can be found by the river sort of thing, like it's that connection to the river. They live along the river.
Is it like a living life, living water?
Oh, metaphor, and this is metaphor, metaphoric stuff, eh? Living.
Fantastic. This is all great for research. Right. But,
foundation.
Yes, that's all great. Now, there's one thing that's
one
got to come through. What is it?
Is that a source?
Is that physical connection, the spiritual connection to the
own? Connection. And what is connection?
Relationships.
Pēhea tō tūhuetanga. Pēhea tō tainuitanga. Pēhea tō tūranawawaitanga. What does that tell us?
It's our ancestors.
Where are we what? Where we come from?
Where we were.
Our
tūranga wai.
Yes.
Foundation.
Pillar to the ground.
Foundation.
Not only in terms of where we were born, well, of where we live, but where we were born in Māori terms. We're talking about I te ao Māori. We're only looking at others so that you have a better idea of what they are. Okay, so it's all about
identity.
That's right. You're identifying in no uncertain terms where you come from. Anei māua a mātātua. We're not saying wire mu e ngā huia. We're saying anei māua a mātātua.
We are.
Anei koe, te awa. Anei kōrua, tainui. It's stamping your feet right where you belong. In fact, it's sort of ka titi your wāwai ki te whenua. That's what he's saying. So, when you have a look at what you see, Kapai, she's linking her whakapapa. It's really all about whakapapa, but not really whakapapa, but that's what moves our world, our Māori world.
Te ao marama, whakapapa.
Connections, relationships. Pono hono I te tangata, tana whenua. Kaua ko te whenua ki te tangata, not the people to the land to the people. Why? Hea hai?
Hawaii.
Why? Talk about why the land and our environment is more important than people. Go look to your friend again. 1 minute.
The land is the only
Yep.
Land never goes away.
No, we'll die. We'll get chucked on the mountain.
Some of our land goes overseas.
She was talking about the river before we move around again. She was talking about the river connections. Why is the environment more important than people?
It remains. People move, people die, people move on, but the land
Good.
Will remain.
Right.
Spot on. People move. Hey, toi tū te whenua. Whatu ngaro ngaro te tangata tō tūtunu te whenua. Environment was here long before us. It will be here when we're gone.
It never leaves.
And that's where the river came in. Okay,
halfway. And Papatūānuku is related to the earth. So it's rather like God, heavens, millions, and upon the earth, God is in the earth.
Well, Papatūānuku is a lot of things, really. That's one way of saying it. Papatūānuku can also be our fire, our earth mother.
Yeah.
Earth mother, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So it depends on what slant you're looking at.
Yeah.
Jesus
lens,
interpreted in those
because
different ways. Okay. Right, now who else? Right.
Oh.
Chris.
Waikato River. Every bend is a tanifa.
Tapai.
Chief.
E tane.